Hello friends, welcome to Freshers Live. Today is 26th April. Here I will discuss all the important questions that may be asked from today's current affairs and important facts related with each question. So watch the video very carefully and try to answer the question asked at the end of the video. You can download the PDF of the latest current affairs from the link provided in the description. You can also download the PDF from our website as well as Telegram groups. Also, you can find the link for the Hindi version of this video in the below given description box. The link for the Hindi current affairs is given there. Before moving forward, let's check the answer for the question asked in the last video. NABARD was established on the recommendations of Dash. The correct answer is option A, B. Shivaraman Committee. Now let's begin our session for today. Here comes our question number 1. What is the rank of India in Asian Athletics Championship 2019 held in Doha, Qatar? The correct answer is option B, 4th. India bagged 17 medals overall, including 3 gold, 7 silver and 7 bronze medals, and finished 4th in the 2019 Asian Athletics Championship. China tops the medal table of 2019 Asian Athletics Championship with 29 medals in the total. Bahrain with 22 medals and Japan with 18 medals secured 2nd and 3rd place respectively in medal table. The 2019 Asian Athletics Championship was the 23rd edition of the Asian Athletics Championship held from 21 to 24th April 2019 at the Khalifa International Stadium in Doha, Qatar. Over 43 nations participated in the event. It will serve as the test event for the 2019 Athletics World Championship, which are being held at the same venue. Last year, Asian Athletics Championship was held in Bhubaneswar, India. Now let me share few more information about the India's gold medal winner at 2019 Asian Athletics Championship. Gomati Marimuthu has won India's first gold medal of the Asian Athletics Championship 2019 in 800 meter race after clocking 2 minutes 2.70 seconds. Tejinder Pal Singh Tur won gold medal in men's short put event. PU Chitra won gold in women's 1500 meter event after clocking 4:14.56 seconds to become the first Indian athlete to defeat her Asian Athletics Championship in the 2019 meet. Heading to our question number 2. Who won the Rabindranath Tagore Literary Prize 2019? The correct answer is option B, Rana Dasgupta. The Rabindranath Tagore Literary Prize 2019 was awarded to author Rana Dasgupta. He was awarded for his 2010 novel Solo, which is a tale of estrangement and the ultimate failure of material existence. Rabindranath Tagore Literacy Prize aims to revive poetry and books that can change lives. An amount of $10,000, a Tagore statue and a certificate of contribution to literature will be given to the awardee. The other awardees are Yohei Sasakawa, the World Health Organization Goodwill Ambassador for Leprosy Elimination, was awarded the Rabindranath Tagore Literacy Prize for Social Achievement. Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen was awarded as a beacon of democracy. Now let me share a few more information about Tagore Awards. Tagore Prize was launched with a strong vision to be a platform and a vehicle for improving and inspiring world peace, literature, art and education. It promotes the culture and beauty of literature and society of tolerance, harmony and non-discrimination. Heading to our question number 3. Which life insurance company collaborated with MobiQuick to launch a smart digital insurance product to enhance financial inclusion? The correct answer is option D, Aegon Life Insurance. MobiQuick Digital Financial Services Company collaborated with pioneer of digital insurance in India. Aegon Life Insurance planned to launch a Rs 20 smart digital insurance product in order to protect its wallet users from death and accident related disability cover for up to Rs 2 lakh. The main objective for this initiative is to improve the insurance penetration in India, that is to drive financial inclusion of the masses. The company has created three variants of the amount assured between Rs 1 lakh, Rs 1.5 lakh and 2 lakh at no extra cost, and the policy can be availed at a premium of Rs 20, Rs 30 and Rs 40 respectively, depending on the protection amount, and this is issued instantly. The insurance product launched is termed as the Aegon Life Group Term Plus Plan. It is available on MobiQuick app. An user can purchase this plan by paying Rs 20 in premium for a sum assured of Rs 2 lakh, which includes both term insurance and accidental disability. Now let me share few more informations about MobiQuick. The industry is digital wallets, e-commerce payment system. It was founded in the year April 2009. The founder is Bipin Preet Singh Upasana Thakur. It is headquartered at Gurgaon, India. Heading to our question number 4. Which country created world's first artificial crater on asteroid? The correct answer is option A, Japan. Japanese scientists successfully created the first ever artificial crater on an asteroid, which gave some clue on how the solar system evolved. Hayabusa too confirmed the crater from images captured by the probe located 1700 meters from the asteroid surface. Hayabusa 2 space probe shot a projectile at Yugo asteroid around 340 million kilometers from Earth as part of the probe's mission to explore the origin of life and the evolution of the solar system. The mission was launched in December 2014 and is scheduled to return to Earth with its sample in 2020 with a total cost around 30 billion yen. Now let me share a few more informations about Japan. The emperor is Akihito. The prime minister is Shinzo Abe. The capital is Tokyo and the currency is yen and the national language is Japanese. Moving to our question number 5. Which organization recently issued the first ever screen time guidelines for children under 5 years of age? The correct answer is option D, World Health Organization. The UN Health Agency, World Health Organization, has released new guidelines on physical activity, sedentary, and sleep for children under 5 years of age. It also issued its first ever guidance for how much screen time children should be allowed, limited, and none at all for 1-year-olds. Now let me share few more informations about new screen time guidelines for children under 5. Kids under 5 should not spend more than 1 hour watching screen every day, and that less is better. Infants under 1 year should not be exposed to electronic screens. WHO stated that ensuring quality sleep, improving physical activity, and reducing sedentary time in younger age will boost their physical, mental health and well-being. This will also help prevent childhood obesity and associated diseases later in life. Kids between the age of 1 and 3 should spend 3 hours a day during physical activity. Now, let me share the information about World Health Organization. It is headquartered at Geneva, Switzerland. The head is Tedros Adhanom. It was founded on 7th April 1948. The goal of WHO is to promote and protect health through healthy eating and physical activity. Moving to our question number, when is the World Intellectual Property Day observed? The correct answer is option D, 26th April. World Intellectual Property Day is observed annually on 26th April. The theme for 2019 is Reach for Gold, IP and Sports. The event was established by the World Intellectual Property Organization in 2000. The aim is to raise awareness of how patents, copyright, trademarks and design impact on daily life and to celebrate creativity and the contribution made by creators and innovators to the development of societies across the globe. Now let me share few more informations about the World Intellectual Property Organization. It was formed on 14th July 1967. It is headquartered at Geneva, Switzerland. The Director General is Francis Gurry. The member states are 191. The parent is United Nations Economic and Social Council. WIPO is one of the 15 specialized agencies of the United Nations. It was created to encourage creative activity to promote the protection of intellectual property throughout the world. Heading to our question number 7. Which country has temporarily banned drones, unmanned aircraft after Easter bombings? The correct answer is option B, Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka banned the use of drones and unmanned aircraft following the massive Easter Sunday bombings that killed over 350 people and injured more than 500 in the country's worst terror attack. The ban will be in effect until further notice. The use of the drones and unmanned aircraft has been temporarily banned within the Sri Lanka airspace. Now let me share few more informations about Sri Lanka. The capital is Colombo, Sri Jayawardenapuri Kotte, trending. The currency is Sri Lankan rupee. The Prime Minister is Ranil Wickremesinghe. The President is Maithripala Sirisena. Heading to our question number 8. Which bank launched India's first green car loan at lower interest rates? The correct answer is option C, State Bank of India. In a first, India's largest bank, State Bank of India, launched green car loan to encourage customers to buy electric vehicles in the country. The interest rate on the loan will be 20 basis points lower than SBI's existing auto loans. Thus, the equated monthly installment per rupees 1 lakh will be lower at rupees 1468 for 96 months, that is 8 years, against rupees 1622 for 84 months based on the maximum tenure of existing schemes. The scheme comes with the longest repayment period of up to 8 years. The loan is offered with zero processing fee for the first 6 months of the launch. SBI along with Wipro joined the Climate Group's EV100 initiative for enhancing the launch of electric vehicle worldwide. Now let me share few more informations about the State Bank of India. It is an Indian multinational public sector bank. It was founded on 1st July 1955. It is headquartered at Mumbai and the chairperson is Rajneesh Kumar. Heading to our question number 9. What is the current status of Indian Army in inducting women as jawans? The correct answer is Option A, started to induct. The Indian Army has stated the process of inducting women as jovens by starting their online registration for recruitment in the corps of military police. Until now, women were being inducted only as officers, and this is the first time they would be taken as soldiers. Women will be inducted in a graded manner to eventually comprise 20% of the total corps of military police. Accordingly, the army chalked out induction of approximately 800 women in military police with a yearly intake of 52 personnel per year. The role of the military police includes policing cantonments and army establishments, preventing the breach of rules and regulations by soldiers, maintaining movement of soldiers as well as logistics during peace and war, handling prisoners of war and extending aid to civil police. Now let me share a few more informations about Indian Army. It was founded on 1st April 1895. It is a part of Indian Armed Forces. It is headquartered at New Delhi. The motto is to service before self. Commander-in-Chief is President Ramnath Kovind. The Chief of the Army Staff is General Bipin Rawat. The Vice Chief of the Army Staff is Lieutenant General Devraj Anbu. Heading to our last question, question number 10. Which pair won their second World Cup gold in the 10-minute air pistol mixed team event at the ISSF World Cup 2019 in Beijing? The correct answer is option A, Manu Becker and Saurabh Chaudhary. India's 16-year-old Saurabh Chaudhary and 17-year-old Manu Becker won gold in the 10-meter air pistol mixed team event at the ISSF World Cup 2019 in Beijing. Becker and Chaudhary outshot Jiang Ruixing and Pang Wei of China 16-6 in the final. This is the second consecutive gold for Manu Becker and Saurabh Chaudhary at the ISSF World Cup, as they have clinched a gold in the same category in the New Delhi edition of the Shooting World Cup in February this year. Anjum Maudgal and Divyansh Singh Panwar bagged a gold medal in the 10-meter air rifle mixed team event in the same tournament. Now let me share a few more informations about the ISSF World Cup 2019. It is governed by International Shooting Sport Federation. It is the qualification tournament for the 2020 Olympics Games. It was first introduced in the year 1986. It is carried out with four competitions per year in each event. 2019 World Cup 1 venue was New Delhi, India. World Cup 2 venue was Beijing, China. World Cup 3 venue was Munich, Germany, and the World Cup 4 venue is Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. To conclude this session, here comes the question of the day. Who is the first non-European to win the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1913? Try to answer the question and drop your answer in the comment box. Okay friends, that's for today. Thanks for watching our video. If you find the information provided in our video useful, please do like, share and subscribe our YouTube channel. Follow us regularly to stay updated on current affairs. Dear friends, are you looking for a job? End your search now. Visit freshersline.com, the next generation of placement network. Register yourself today and get placed in top companies. Until then, this is Freshers Life signing out from Current Affairs video. Take care.